Some products come in a box, nice packaging, they're out on a shelf. Other products come in Ziploc bags and bubble wrap. Those products being ones that you send me. My audience members send products here. Some are made with a 3D printer, some are fabricated in other ways. But in any case, it's interesting because these are not necessarily the things that the industry thinks they can sell. It's stuff that individual mountain bikers find a need for and make themselves. And so we're gonna review these products today. Let's start with this one over here. And these are called Mend-It kits. This is a first aid kit, but it looks different from any first aid kit I've ever seen. So first, let me show you another first aid kit. This is like what you would order if you just typed in first aid kit. And honestly, with what's in here, it's like band-aids, scrapes, cuts, things like that. These first aid kits are really not that capable. This seems way more specific to mountain biking. Broken bones. Big wounds. Not trying to scare anyone away from the sport, but at least they're being realistic. Okay, so they have a big strap on here so that you can wrap it around your frame and actually tie it to your bike. I assume this strap also doubles as the tourniquet. Yes, you can wrap this around somebody's body part, and then you can turn this and it'll keep making it tighter and tighter and tighter. Ooh, it's an actual tourniquet. Here's some more stuff in here. You've got Advil and bandages and gauze and all the things that you would find in all of these first aid kits. Oh, here we go. You could use this as a brace in so many different situations. It's got metal on the inside, and so you can form it to the shape of somebody's wrist. Also has some good guidance for head, neck, and back injury, lacerations and skin abrasions, suspected broken bone. That's good, because I don't know any first aid. Now, my main criticism would be that it's kind of big. Even if you're gonna strap this to your bike, this is not something that people are going to bring with them on every ride. But if there's a big group of people and one person brings this, or a mountain bike guide, or patrol, or a trail builder, I can see that somebody who wants to be prepared for a specific situation would honestly find no better option than this. And so, Mend-It kits, this is honestly one of the most capable first aid kits I've ever seen for a mountain biker. Good job. And this must be from the South because there's a cheerwine cap. These look like bar ends. This looks like a 3D printed stem cap. And this is the top cap for a fork. Now all this stuff makes sense. So this is just a way to put bottle caps on your bike as decoration. That's fun. So it's a product that lets you install bottle caps on your bike, and it does technically keep dirt out of the bolt that is there. And I suspect there aren't any other products out there like this. I get a lot of unoriginal stuff. This is original. Multi-tool valve caps. Schrader for BMX and Presta for mountain bike. The notch at the top of both caps can be used to tighten spokes. The Presta-type valve cap has a valve core remover. And he did say these are prototypes, like a real version of this would be made of metal. This is just an example. It's a cool idea. I think it works well enough, and your valve cap is kind of an untapped tool mounting location on your bike. Very interesting, good job. Okay, Riley here made some tools in his garage. This is way better quality than I was expecting for some reason. This looks like a rotor truing fork, and it has a nice angle in it so you can get to it from outside the bike. Very interesting, and it feels durable. See what this next one is. Yeah, I can't overstate how surprisingly good the quality is. So this is a truly useful shop tool. We have this giant pedal wrench with tons of leverage, fits right on a pedal. Then if you're removing a cassette or a freewheel, your cassette or freewheel tool fits right in here, kind of better than anything else I own. This is awesome. What else we got here? Now I have high hopes. Okay, what the heck is this? I don't know what this is, but it's really cool. cassette pliers. Okay, let me show you what this is for. Okay, so if I want to remove this cassette, there is a lock ring over here that I can turn with this tool. So we insert this tool. We use this one for leverage, but as you can see, it just turns the cassette like your bike is coasting. So we have to hold it still. Now these are cassette pliers that Park Tool makes. There's also a tool called the chain whip, and it can basically hold onto your cassette so that you can hold it still when you're taking it off. Riley's tool is just these steel teeth that go around the cassette. I don't know how I feel about that. I mean, damn, that's really nice. Now, I know what a lot of you are thinking, and I'm kind of thinking the same thing. Is this good for the cassette? Your cassette might be made of aluminum or something, and now you have these steel teeth on it. I don't think to hold it still for one revolution, it's gonna make any difference. After all, your chain is steel and putting tons of torque on your cassette all day. Pretty impressive. These are some very slick tools, and I think we got one more. Valve core wrench. Nicest valve core wrench I own. This is gonna definitely stay out in the shop. Riley, I'm glad you're making bike tools. Next product I'm gonna show you comes from me. These little stubby hex drivers. I use these just for bottle cages. And so I have all the sizes that you would find a bottle cage bolt in, and you can get right in there without your wrench getting in the way of stuff. And so the reason I'm using this right now is to install the bottle cage that somebody sent me. It's a bottle cage designed for a Nalgene bottle. And so I would say that this has been done a million times and it's not original, except this is particularly well designed. It's really sturdy. And I just see limited ways that it could get cracked or damaged. And so I don't have much more to say about it. Besides that, we've already tested a Nalgene bottle cage. This is just a little thicker and more robust than other ones I've seen. And looks real good. And I especially admire this subscriber because he mowed lawns all summer to save up for a Prusa 3D printer that he designed these on. I guess he had met Kevin at Canuga last year, and he keeps a 1997 GT mountain bike going. So Adam from Cleveland, I admire that very much, and I'd say you have a bright future. Now, what I will say is the other Nalgene bottle cage that I reviewed had a way to keep it from coming out like this. I don't think it's gonna be a problem. It's a bash guard. Not only that, but at $27.99, it's one of the most affordable bash guards you can get. But if this individual followed Berm Peak, they would know that we already tried making actual bike parts on the 3D printer and didn't work out so hot. Ooh. And so, I don't know, let's try it. This does look like a really thick, really strong 3D printed part. Designed to protect your mountain bike frame and drivetrain from rocks, logs, and roots, these are 3D printed from durable PETG plastic. I guess there's only one way to find out if this protects your chain ring. So bash guards take as much abuse as any bike part you could ever imagine, and this one held up just fine. Somehow I couldn't design any 3D printed parts that would survive on a bike, but somehow this individual made a bash guard that survives. Would it survive to a really high speed impact with a rock? I don't know, but I'm pretty impressed so far, so good job. Enclosed are two to try out. Adjust the tension straps until you can hold the handlebar and the pad is relatively snug against the bar, but not getting in the way. I call it a wrist wedge. I hope you like them. I still can't understand even slightly what this does. So it looks like you put your wrist through here and then you put your finger through here. I guess it's a wrist brace, and then you can tighten this down to like Yeah, I don't understand it. Okay, so this is a teaching moment for anybody sending these products. I get these messages that sort of explain what it does. Put yourself in my shoes with no information. I open up the package. You have to tell me what it does. It doesn't say whether it's a wrist brace or whether it's for somebody with a hand problem or anything. It looks well thought out, but I don't know what it does. But thanks for sending it. This one looks a little more self-explanatory, but does seem to include instructions. So what it looks like here is this individual included a bunch of little 3D printed things. One of them being an adapter to add bottle cage mounts anywhere on your bike. That's kind of cool. And then they've also included these plates, which is for mounting things with straps. So first of all, this little mounting plate has a spot for quick links. So as you can see now, we have a perfect mounting plate to strap a tube down to the bike. So we can just take this strap, go over the tube, and we can strap it on with one of these gear straps. Can you strap a tube to your bike without this? Yes, of course. But this is just a proof of concept. You can install a pump, a storage container, or an extra water bottle. There's lots of things that attach to bottle cage mounts, and so this is pretty cool. One suggestion I would make in future iterations of this design, put a piece of metal or a little nut behind it for those bottle cage bolts. I just went straight in thinking it was there and marked up my frame because the bolt went through and smacked into the carbon. But luckily, I don't care about scratching my bike. So that's all the products we have for today. Hopefully, as the weather warms up, we'll get more in. But guys, keep this stuff coming. I'm actually really, really impressed with a couple of these products, namely the tools. These are really cool. I'm gonna use a few of these and keep them out. And the 3D printed bash guard kind of stole the show. I tried to 3D print all sorts of bike products, and things that take less abuse than a bash guard broke right away. So for something made from home, this is excellent. And so from time to time, I make these announcements on Instagram stories. Hey, send me your products. Now I'm making it here. Go to my website, follow the link below. If you are a home tinkerer, send us a message and send something over, and maybe it'll end up in one of these videos if it's interesting enough. I hope you found this interesting. I hope some of you learned something. And if you didn't get either of those things out of it, I hope you at least found it entertaining. Thanks for riding with me today. I'll see you next time.